What we are talking about here is a serious issue, and we're being kind of playful so far. But you know, when it comes to confinement, personally, I just think it's an unacceptable thing, and I think that. But to most of it's largely invisible, and we're given the privilege of not actually thinking about it very often. You know, it's when I think about humanity over the long haul, we have shed various archaic behaviors over the years that to now, and when we look back on them, they seem appalling. You know, 150 years ago, we thought we could have slaves. And now we can't even imagine that. You know, it wasn't so long ago that women were thought that could not vote. You know, what were we thinking? You know, what were we thinking? Well, you know, I wonder if someday we're going to look back on the idea that we're torturing animals on a mass scale, daily, billions of animals, and thinking that's okay. It's not okay. And, you know, but you know, on the other hand, eating meat is deeply ingrained in our culture. I grew up eating meat. Donna grew up eating meat, and most everybody in this room grew up eating meat, and we all have our own journey as to how we want to depart from that place. There's no right or wrong way to do it. You could be, for instance, you know, eat one less piece of meat a year, or a week, or a month, or you could become a complete vegetarian. But it's there's no right or wrong way.
You could go to ONF and buy this awesome locally grown meat.
That's true.
Strangely enough,
being a lifelong vegetarian, we have absolutely nothing wrong with people that eat meat if it's done responsibly. You know, people think we should not like hunters, but hunters, they're going out there and they're doing the thing themselves, you know, and they're taking personal responsibility for it.
Okay,
you know,
I got a question. Okay. Did you all get to see the cranky up there?
Yeah.
If you didn't, I hope you, when you're done, I hope you'll go up there. I want to thank Stephen Kober and Taylor for operating it, and Jules and Paige for helping round you all up and last year when you get your face to see it. One of my other sheroes, somebody I love so much, is Emily the Cat, and that's what the story is about. And this is her song.
That's true. This is Emily's kind of the mascot for this whole event, and very much inspired the event, to tell you the truth. Now you gotta come over here. And this is it's not the world premiere. We played this at the Unitarian Church on Sunday, but this is the second time it's ever been played, and it's a lovely song the daughter wrote for Emily the Cat.
Do you remember a cold November when a two-year-old heifer on her way to slaughter jumped a five-foot fence? Kept it clean out of sight, 40 days and nights. She kept clean out of sight. Newspaper ran stories about her bravery, a bovine celebrity. Town folk called her Emily. A young Quaker family from the Peace Abbey fell in love with Emily, made a solemn vow to rescue her somehow. And so for many a day, they brought sweet grain and hay. They gained her trust that way. Then on Christmas evening, made the starry, starry night, she let them lead her homeward. The barn was warm and Christmas songs for Emily, joy to the world. They sang lovingly, finally out of danger. Away in a manger, they watched the North Star rise on that holy night. For 9 long years she lived and thrived, a poster child for animal rights. Cancer finally took her life, but all around the globe, her legend grows and grows, a tale of love and hope. televisions ran stories about her bravery. She put a face on cruelty, the sacred cow named Emily. Now in love and memory, a life-size statue stands between one of Mother Teresa and Mahatma Gandhi. And in that statue's ear, there hangs a golden thread, where a numbered tag had been Silent Night, Holy Night. All is calm, all is bright. Do you remember a cold November when a two-year-old heifer on her way to slaughter jumped a five-foot fence?
Just before we get started also, just to wrap things up a little bit, one more time, I just want to make it perfectly clear that what we really want to happen today, that what we want to come out of this event, is to start a conversation and to begin a journey towards doing something right about the issue of confinement. I think most of us can agree that it's an unacceptable thing. And I hope today that when you go home today, I hope you'll be inspired to think about it. And just think about what you're eating and where it came from. And there are good options. And as you see, there's many vendors
that
supply food today. And by the way, I didn't want to say anything, but you guys ate like pigs.